Hi, everybody, and welcome. My name is Luke, and this is The Science Lens, where I show you how science can improve your critical thinking skills. In today's episode, I'm going to talk about some of the reasons people share misinformation online by focusing on five cognitive biases. I'll then offer a suggestion for how we can all help stop the flow of misinformation online. Okay, let's get started. When surveyed, most people agree that it's important to only share factual news. As well as that, most people are actually pretty good at distinguishing fake or highly biased headlines from true ones. So if most people want to share accurate information and are pretty good at identifying it, why does so much misinformation circulate online? Well, the answer to that question is long and complex. So to keep this video under 12 hours, I'm just going to focus on five cognitive biases that play a role in causing us to share misinformation. Number one, the halo effect. The halo effect is a bias that makes us more trusting of a person because of some positive characteristic. So maybe they seem smart or attractive or powerful. If you follow influencers on social media, it's likely you do so because you find them charismatic or interesting in some way. After all, you don't get to 100,000 followers by being dull and unappealing. By the way, how do you get to 100,000 followers? Asking for a friend. But of course, traits like power and charisma have no bearing on the quality of information that a person is presenting, and so we need to be careful when resharing it. 2. In-group bias. We have a tendency to favor people that we see as being part of our team or in-group. This could be because we have something in common like nationality or political beliefs, but it's such a powerful bias that if you separate people into groups randomly, they start to develop an us versus them attitude. The in-group bias can have a significant effect on our decisions of what information we share online. A recent study published in Nature showed that participants were more likely to share information that aligned with their political views, regardless of whether the information was true or not. The affect heuristic. The word affect in psychology just means anything related to emotion, and heuristics are mental shortcuts that our brains take when processing information. So the affect heuristic is just our brain's way of making quick decisions based on emotion. It's no secret that a lot of misinformation on the internet evokes fear in people reading it, and it can really impact a person's behavior if they feel like they can do something to avoid being harmed. But we also have a tendency to share information that evokes other emotions such as anger, joy, or sadness. 4. The bandwagon effect. The bandwagon effect is when people tend to believe something just because they see other people believe it. So if all of your friends on social media are sharing the same story, you'll be more likely to share it too. This effect was demonstrated in an article in Science magazine where people were shown posts on a social media platform. If people encountered a post that already had a lot of likes and upvotes, they were much more likely to upvote it themselves. Number 5, the illusory truth effect. Finally, there's the illusory truth effect, which is our tendency to believe something just because it's repeated. This is such a strong bias that even if we know that a piece of information is false the first time we hear it, if we keep hearing it, we come to believe that it's true and we'll be more likely to share it. Before I continue, I just have a small request that if you're enjoying the video so far, please click the like button below and subscribe if you'd like to see more videos like it. Okay, continuing on. So being aware of these biases is one thing, but how can we use that awareness to help slow the spread of misinformation? Well, the answer is deceptively simple. Just slow down. People are bombarded with so much information these days that we tend to make quick decisions about what to share so that we can move on to the next thing. But according to an article published in Nature, people choose to share much less misinformation if they're simply asked the question, is this reliable? Asking people to pause and consider the accuracy of information gave them time to think critically about it rather than relying on their biases. So all you need to do is take a beat before clicking the share button. Unless you're thinking about sharing this video, in which case you should do that immediately. Well, that's it from me for today, but if you'd like some resources to help you practice the concepts that I covered, I recommend that you check out my store on TPT. There I have a range of worksheets and templates for teaching critical thinking in the science classroom, and you can find a link to that down in the description below. Also, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe if you'd like to see more videos on how science can improve your critical thinking skills. And finally, I used a bunch of resources to help out with this video today, so if you'd like more information on the things that I covered, I recommend that you check those out as well. They're also linked down below. For now though, that's it from me. Thanks for watching.